Hi, I'm Zach, and I've launched and designed FreshService from the ground up. And today I'm going to talk to you about what I think is the most important function of FreshService, and that's called custom objects. We're going to walk through how to build a robust application process, and most importantly, make it long-term scalable. Your portal might look something like this. Maybe you have a few more apps, maybe you've consolidated down into one form. Either way, a process like this will work for you. If you've got these apps, you probably have approval processes, and you want to control cost and maybe potentially control access. And if you wanted to keep something simple, you might build workflows like this. This workflow says, when a service request is raised and that requested item is Adobe Illustrator, then send to the reporting manager. If it's approved or rejected, a respective note will come. Now, that means you have a one-to-one workflow. If you have 20 different apps, you have 20 different workflows. And as those become more complicated, it just becomes a non-scalable solution. Maybe you got a little bit more creative and you built out a multi-workflow. You started grouping them together based on their approval types. Here you're saying if the service request is raised and it's a software installation and the requested item is Adobe Illustrator or Adobe InDesign, then send it to reporting manager. And now that's not the only path. It's possible that it's Adobe Photoshop, and now it needs to go through reporting manager approval and application approver. Now you're going to have to hard code in application approver as it will change per app. And that's what I'm hinting to in that this is also not scalable. You may be able to get away with a few being grouped together, but ultimately as you add more additional apps that may need additional workflows or potentially different workflows, you're not going to be able to do that as you'll need to hard code every application approver. And like I mentioned, if you have 20 different apps, you may have 20 different app approvals if they're not going to reporting manager. Now that's where you talk about introducing custom objects. Custom objects are basically databases, or in a simpler term, a spreadsheet that can store a ton of workflow data in a nice, easily editable location. It's also really easy to scale and really easy to export should other teams need access to that information. Before I jump into the final workflow, the thing you've all been waiting for, I'm going to show you an example of how a custom object can manage applications. Every company is going to look a little bit different, so my custom object might not align exactly to your workflows, but I've seen this work in four different organizations with just a little bit of adaptation. For the sake of time, I can't go into every detail of every column and how it would work, but I would recommend pausing to take a look at the ideas for your organization. You should start by building a main database of all of your applications. It can look something like this. Under object records, you can see we have a bunch of pre-filled information. This is where I would recommend pausing to get ideas for your org on how you can build out your custom object. I think all of these are really great and useful columns, but we're going to only talk about a few of these as they're relevant to the last workflow. The first column is application name. This is going to match your service request name and be the way that you can tie these two things together so it matches the proper row with the proper documentation that you need to use within the workflow. Application owner will skip over. Application approver and application approval type, these columns here, are both going to tell you how the application is going to be approved, and if there is an additional approver outside of the reporting manager, who is that person for each app? And in this case, you can see that this application requires application approver and reporting manager, and that application approver is the sandbox user. So we'll talk about what that looks like in the workflow later. Provisioning articles, provisioning method, and tags are all ways that we can sort of add to the workflow, and we'll show you that as well. But just know this is information you can populate into the ticket as it's going through its approval process. The last one I'm going to mention is agent group, because I think that is one of the most powerful tools. Each application can have a specific agent group that they are routed to. And so that can change between the help desk team to the sysadmin team to the networking team based on who would grant that access. So again, this is just a very brief overview of the custom object. I do want to mention that the application approval type is actually a nested custom object. So I'm going ahead and recommend that you pause here as well, and you can see how we're using those data sources. So as I mentioned, application approval is referencing a different custom object, and this just allows us to have consistent records. So if I go ahead and click on this, I can show you. There is very specific dropdowns I can choose here. I can't type in reporting manager or possibly make a mistake in typing that. I am going to select this. And if the workflow grows, you can actually add more options here by editing the other custom object. So we've taken a look at the custom object. So let's jump into the final workflow. We're gonna bounce back and forth so you can see how the fields are used. We're also going to go a little bit slower with this one, as this is the final product you can set up for your business. Just like the other ones, the first thing is a service request is raised, and then it's double checking that it's a software installation. The reason why we do this, by the way, is so we don't accidentally kick this off for something like a MacBook provisioning. And then the real magic happens when you pull in a reader node. So what this does is it reads from our custom object, which we called applications, and then it takes the application name and looks for a match in the service request item name. So as I mentioned, application name should match your service request item because then you can compare the two. If you don't have that, you'll have to find a different way to identify what app we should be reading to. And also, if you want to know where this information is, you can go into service item and requested items and it will drop in this placeholder. Or you could quite literally copy this as it's the same for all orgs. Now that we've got that reader node in, anytime we want to refer to that reader node, you can add in an R1 tag, and we'll go ahead and take what that looks like here. So this is going to do a bunch of things that actually the older workflows weren't doing. The first thing it's going to do is tag. I mentioned before that R1 means the reader node 1, and if you have multiple readers, you'll see R1, R2, R3, R4, and this is just a way to identify what reader that is. So this is pulling in R1 and then pulling in that tag field. And with Premier, for our example, you can see that Premier is right here and it's going to tag in that ticket automatically. The other thing it's going to do is pull in the provisioning article and write a private note to your technicians on how to provision this app. And that information is stored under the custom object as well. And lastly, just like you've seen with the rest of them, R1 agent group is going to pull in the specific agent group and assign it to them based on what the app that was selected. So this is already a lot more than the older workflows were doing and with a lot more ease. And it's dynamic. Regardless of what app is selected, it will do that for you. The next one is going to check what type of approval process should happen. So in here you can see there is approval type reporting manager, approval type application approver, and then there's a dot dot dot, which is actually saying application approver and reporting manager. To not bore you, we're just going to go down that path as that is what Adobe Premiere is, application approver and reporting manager. So that would hit that condition. It would go in and automatically assign approval to the reporting manager, which we've seen in the past. But then where the real magic happens, it's also going to then, once it's approved by the reporting manager, assign to the specific app approval that is listed in the custom object. And in this case, I think it's something like the sandbox user, but in other cases, you could see it be a very specific, maybe application owner or someone that wants to control the spend. So before you would have had to hard code this information in for all 20 apps. Now you can simply put it in your custom object and forget about it as that placeholder will be filled into this workflow. And then just to take it way over the edge, the last thing you can do is write a private note to your technician, letting them know it's been approved. And this is how the app is provisioned, because if we store the provisioning method, which we very briefly talked about, you can actually store additional information here and serve that to your technicians that are looking at the ticket. You could put anything in here. You could put a step-by-step KB. You could just put a closing note, maybe something easy that they can copy and paste. It's just a great way to take some of that information from the custom object and display it to the technician. So we talked about a lot. I know this is a lot. I do recommend you pausing at each stage so you can see how it was set up and also maybe how you can set it up in your org. If you're going to look to build this out yourself, I would recommend adding actually two additional columns to your custom object. One of them being category and the other being subcategory. This is already automatically routing your ticket, automatically tagging it. It can actually just do it all for you and automatically categorize it with both the category and subcategory. And this can be used as part of this stage that we were seeing here. So I would challenge you to sort of add that in as just an additional challenge that wasn't documented here. But just know this whole process is very scalable. Anytime you need to add a new app, you can simply add a new row in that spreadsheet or the custom object, and I challenge you to start small and naturally build up. Maybe sometime you can build out a fully automated provisioning process from beginning to end that has approval, provisioning, and all of the above, kicking out APIs and everything. But at the very least, start very small. You've got this. I think you can do great. And remember, go back and pause the video because you can do this yourself.